And, you know, I don't understand that. I went through it a little while myself, as far as the concept and the idea of being with somebody and trying to gain an understanding of, you know, where they fit in your life, you know, from the very beginning of just talking to them to the point of you're dating them or you get married to them or, you know, whatever the case may be. And I'm not
sorry.
Yeah, all good. But I don't understand when with some people how they'll sit and talk to the same person for, you know, 2, 3, 4 years, but keep playing this you know, back and forth thing of, you know, yeah, I like you, then, well, no, I don't. Yeah, I like you, then, oh, no, I don't. And, it, you know, that kind of fucking thing. And it's like, what the hell is your fucking issue? Because you're not making any fucking sense. Like, and I know women and men both do this, because I've been a victim of the I like you, I don't like you game. And it's fucking retarded. You know, after being with somebody, you know if you like that person or not. You could actually identify if you like somebody within the first 10 minutes of actual conversation with them than 6 months of dating. You either like that person or you don't. It's that simple.
Well, I do have to say, I agree with you to that on a point, you know, with being able to tell if you like somebody within a certain amount of time of talking to them or whatnot. But then again, you know, you got two-faced people out there too who,
yeah,
that's what I was gonna say.
That's what I said, though. That's where I've been the victim of that game too, though, because I sat and talked to somebody for a while and then turn around and got stabbed in the fucking back, you know, by him. And it's like, what the fuck happened? What the fuck did I do to you? You know, and it, you know, wasn't anything that I did. It was just that person's mentality and that person's way of playing fucking games, you know. Guys are just as guilty of it. Guys, I think, are more guilty of that than women are, because I think women are more accepting of a commitment and that kind of thing, and guys are kind of standoffish when it comes to it. But at this point, it was, you know, at that point in time for me, it was like the role was reversed. And it wasn't that I wasn't or was. It just kind of fucking happened that way. You know, I got fucked over by somebody that, you know, said they cared and then didn't. You know, it is what it is.
Nah, I agree with you on that, man. I mean, you know, we've personally seen it happen, and it sucks. It does. But, you know, I don't know. You know, you find out true people's colors the hard way sometimes, you know.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Try to let you know that they're either being a brother or a sister or whatever the case may be, and they just turned out to be somebody completely different. You know, whether they're jealous of what you got going on, or they just, you know, are douchebags. Just saying.
No, I agree completely. I mean, for me, it's, you know, and I think everybody does it. I don't know. You kind of get in this mode, like, when you're in that mode of looking for somebody so that you can finally be happy and finally settle down, shit like that kind of just leads you to the right person, because then it just shows you another aspect of something to look for and watch out for and understand. And that's kind of where I end up with, you know, the one I'm with. You know, I got fucking lucky as fuck when I met her. I got lucky as fuck, you know. I still feel lucky as fuck, you know, because she has become literally my best fucking friend. And her and I, we do a lot of shit together. We go camping, we go four wheeling, we go, you know, grocery shopping together. You know, I might not stay in the store as long.
Sorry.
Oh, you're fine. Oh, I might not stay in the store as long as she does. And that's just because, you know, after walking around the store for, you know, 35, 40 minutes, my back starts to fucking hurt. So I have to go back to the truck and sit down. Now, otherwise, you know, I end up fucking worse for wear later on in the night.
Right on. What up, big Chris Ripka in the house? We got Beeson. What's going on, y'all? He goes, I don't date. Chris said, I don't date anymore either. My wife kind of frowns on it.
Oh, my gosh.
Chris, you are the Chris is the man. If y'all don't know who Chris Rifke is, man, y'all go check out his page. He does a lot of live feeds and stuff. And sometime after the first, Chris will be joining us on the morning show one morning, and then he is so graciously asked me to jump on his show too as well. So you know, big props to the big man, and you know, we greatly appreciate you listening, Chris. You're funny as shit, dude. He's an awesome vet, and you know, looking forward to being on your show, and we are looking forward to having you on the morning show. Whatnot. So time for that commercial break, and then we'll go into a song, and we shall return.
The Magic Vape Shop. Come on in to the most extreme vape shop in the USA. The Magic Man will slam and mix all your vaping needs at prices you can't beat. With all the vape gear at your fingertips, the Magic Man will provide you with all your desires. See us on the web at themagicvapeshop.com. Let's get vaping.
Yo, this is Jeff.
This is Mark.
I'm Mike.
I'm Craig.
This is Mick.
We are Kings Hollow, and you're tuned into Dangerous Grounds Network.
Yeah. Run by Special Ops veterans, putting people in war zones to work and working where others fear to tread. Each one of our products is manufactured in current or post-conflict areas. Your purchases fund women's education, mining efforts, and healing our veterans. High-quality products that make meaningful change for those less fortunate. What America will be for the world moving forward.
This is Sam from Madison Rising, and you're listening to Dangerous Grounds Network.
This is Rio of Madison Rising, and you're listening to Dangerous Grounds Network. Hey, you want a freedom boner or what? Listen now.
What's up? This is AJ from Madison Rising, and you're listening to Dangerous Grounds Network, and we're going to put a little bit of freedom all up in you.
Who's to know if your soul will fade at all? The one you sold to fool the world. You lost your self-esteem along the way. Yeah.
Good God, you're coming up with reasons. Good God, you're dragging it out. Good God, it's the changing of the seasons. I feel so ranked. So follow me down and just fake it. Won't hide your flaws. No sense in hiding all of yours. You gave up on your dreams along the way. Good God, you're coming up with reasons. Good God, you're dragging it out. Good God, it's the changing of the seasons. I feel so raped. So follow me down and just fake it. Self-esteem along the way. Good God, you're coming up with reasons. Good God, you're dragging it out. Good God, it's the changing of the season. I feel so right, man. Follow me down. Just fake it if you're
Alrighty, there's a little bit of Seether. Fake it! Alright, Ron, man. Be good. Get you something to eat, man. Get your ass back to NC. Get your hairy ass back to NC. Just saying. You can put it in there. Oh, lordy, lordy. So, get into a little bit of sports here. For all you Carolinians who are, pulling for the Panthers and stuff, they got a shot to take the damn division title if New Orleans loses. They have to lose one game or tie, which I don't think they're going to tie anybody, but I don't think they really play anybody that's going to make them fall. But hell, who knows? We've seen teams that are just shit throughout the year and just hammer some of the top dogs. So, just saying. And I ain't really watched a lot of the NFL this year because of the stupid ass protests and bullshit that they decide to pull and whatnot. But that's
the you heard what what was the game that the vice president walked out of? Colts game? Yeah, he walked out of one of the games, and I can't remember whatever game it was. That state's NFL team may end up actually having to pay back people who have season seats that are no longer going to the games because of the protest.
Oh, wow.
Wow. And yeah. Who made this into effect? Was it the commissioner or the MVP?
No, it's not in effect, but the state is looking at this as a course of legal action against a team that has failed to give, okay, look at it from this standpoint. You are, like, say you purchased those season seats 5 years ago under the impression that the NFL represents the greater aspect of what we want from a national pastime sport, i.e. not baseball, but you know what I mean.
Right.
Okay, you buy those tickets because it truly makes you happy to be able to go support your team. Right. What happens when the team doesn't produce the goods? Now, I'm not talking about a losing streak or anything like that, like the Browns and the Bengals deal with on a year-to-year basis, but a legitimate thing that you feel uncomfortable, you feel like the team has completely, just lost your faith in their humanity. And you right. paid for those season seats. They're not producing, they provide a good and goods and service. It's not that they're playing football. They're providing you with entertainment. They are entertainers. That's right. why they're, athletes. They're not producing the end result of that. So a court is now currently looking at it in the aspect, you're not producing the goods. You have season ticket holders and, the general population that have bought tickets that are completely pissed off by this and have not went and been able to, participate, actively, whatever. They're looking at this as a possible court thing where they can go back and say, you're being charged with some sort of crime and we're going to make you reimburse these people for this shit.
And PSL tickets are not cheap at all.
That's what I was about to say. They're expensive as hell, so maybe that'll wake their ass up.
Well, I mean,
I hope they do it.
Yeah, they, let's see what Chris just put in here. Chris said, you usually pay for the season tickets a year or more in advance as well. Right. So, at the Panther Stadium, if you buy PSL tickets, which means you pick a number of seats that you want, and the PSL license itself is